Hey, horse people. I had a couple videos that either were sent or I found or I had stored, and I put them on the side, and I'm like, well, I'll do a video on this kind of later. But this video right here, and I've got a couple others that I got to find, so I'll do a different one. So this will just be two videos. One is this guy gets bucked off, and then the other one is a horse that's floating around Facebook that's I don't know, I've heard it called all kind of different things. We'll get to it in a minute. So, all right, here we have a guy here. First of all, you've got a young, scared horse. Obviously, it's not broke. I say broke. It isn't started properly, but broke's a common term that most people believe. You don't want to break a horse's spirit to break them. If you start them right and you introduce them things right, you don't have to break their spirit in order to be able to ride them. So, the horse has a bit, so we've already got pain there. This guy's a pretty big guy, so if the horse is not used to being ridden at all, obviously a smaller, lighter person is going to be less traumatic than a bigger, heavier guy. So you've got the pain in the mouth, the weight of the guy, and then this guy puts spurs on. And you're going to see this horse trying, and he probably would have done a lot better, but this guy made... Well, what I say is errors, and I'm not cracking on the guy. I mean, these guys are having fun. The guys that videotaped it are just kind of cracking on him and laughing and calling him dummy and calling him a fat guy and all this other stuff. So, I mean, look, it's not the best way. It's not the way that I would do it, but it's been done this way, and I'm just going to show some things on why the horse did what it did or try to explain that. So let's, we'll watch the video once real quick because I think it's only a minute till his butt get bucked off. Horse is telling him I'm scared, I'm nervous, dragging him. Okay, he got off and he gave release and the horse stopped. He should have took that as a clue. He didn't. He just patted the horse's saddle.
Might be okay.
Guy told him to put less boot in the stirrup. That's a good tip.
That goes on the other side.
Problem I got is why the hell's this guy got spurs on? Last thing you need is to accidentally poke a horse that's bucking. You never start a horse with spurs. If you see a guy riding a new horse with spurs, you know you got issues. Because accidents happen. Horse is shaking. Look at his back leg. Shaking. He's nervous. Now, right here, the guy should have got off. The horse stood and let him on. He should have got off and gave the horse release. He didn't. Horse is still in constant pressure. He's nervous. He's got his head pinned, so the horse is kind of locked up.
It only weighs 600.
Now watch him spur him right here.
Buck high enough to get your fat.
Look at him. Watch this spur. Horse stalls. He could have got off any of these times. Look at him, still kicking his leg. Spur him. Boom. Horses. That horse is in fight or flight mode. Let me tell you, man. Look at that head. He is nervous wreck. He's lucky he didn't stomp his ass. So the horse walked over, he got some release, and he stopped the pressure. And you notice the horse is getting distance.
Okay, rewind.
So, I know there's a lot of people that's going to hate on this guy, and horrible, and he should have had a helmet on. And you know, I mean, hell, I'd rather him have a damn helmet on than spurs and a bit to hurt the horse. But, so... You can tell the horse right here got him off and spun. Now, the problem with this is a lot of people will think the guy got off to give the horse release. He didn't. He should have, but that's what you will see. But as a horse, the horse is thinking, if I spin really fast, this guy doesn't get on me. So the horse learned the wrong lesson, which is why you don't want to be getting on a horse, letting a horse move, and stopping pressure when the horse resists. When the horse was spinning and moving, that was resistance, that was fear, that was saying stop. When you stop when a horse tells you to stop, the horse learns, hey, I know how to get this guy to stop. Hang on, I got to do my... So when the horse learns something that you don't want it to learn, that means you're not teaching the right lessons. So this guy taught the wrong lesson. So he stayed here and he didn't give complete release, which is good. He got the horse to stop. The horse said, okay, maybe your foot in the stirrup and you stand next to me ain't a bad thing. When the horse stopped, again, another opportunity to give release. Tell the horse, good job. You don't tell the horse good job by banging on a saddle. You don't tell him good job by saying, oh, you're a good boy. The horse is scared and he's in flight mode. The only thing that tells his horse good is release. But you have to give the release with timing so the lesson that is learned is correct. When you give release with bad timing, you teach the wrong lesson. This horse is learning the wrong lesson. He learned when I spin really quick, the guy won't get on me. Now when I stop, I've tried to stop and see if that'll get me release, and it didn't. The guy continues to hold him and keep that foot in the stirrup, then he gets back on him. Release is the key and the hardest thing to learn with horses, especially people that work with dogs or you work with predatory animals, because pressure on predatory animals are different from pressure on prey animals. Horses have to get released. That is their reward. They don't want your pets. They don't want your hugs. They want release of pressure. So right here, guys, got the horse is saying, dude, if you get away right now, perfect opportunity. Long pause there. That didn't seem like long to me. That's an eternity. Dude, you had several opportunities to say, you know what? This horse isn't ready. He stopped and he gave me something what I did. Let me back away. Let me give him some release. I'm going to go back, put my foot again, see if I get less of a reaction. When I get him to stop again, I'm going to back away. I want to teach a horse, when you stop and let me do something, I'm not going to keep putting pressure on you. You're going to get release. You don't get release if you run. And that's why when you teach horses bad lessons, this horse learned that when I buck and I crow hop and I get really mad and angry and scared, the guy on my back gets off. I run to the other end of the pasture and I get release. That's teaching a horse to get his own release. You don't want to teach that lesson, and too many people out there don't get that. What is the horse learning? Not, you know, they're so focused on what I'm teaching and what I'm learning and what I'm seeing and what I think I'm teaching and what I want to teach and what I feel I'm teaching. They don't get what the horse learns. You got to put yourself in a horse's mind and think like a horse. What is this horse learning?
A little less foot in the stirrup might be okay.
A little less, that's a good tip.
There you go, Bubba.
Dry leg goes on the other side.
So the horse, lots of opportunity for release. The horse is like, dude, I don't know what's going on. Watch this back leg right here. It starts shaking and quivering. This horse is giving all kind of signs. Dude, I'm not ready. You're scaring me. I feel like I'm being attacked. I feel like you're jumping on me. I'm a prey animal. I feel like I'm being attacked by a predator. Now you have spurs on that are hurting me and my mouth is hurting from a bit. Why wouldn't I think a predator was attacking me? All these poor little lessons that this poor little horse, that's trying. This horse is trying.
This is how we killed our friend every.
See that back leg right there? That tail and that quiver?
Afterwards,
that flinching, that tense. Again, another golden opportunity to get off this horse and give this horse release. The best thing you can do when you're starting a horse is the first time you get on, get off. You have to learn. It's all about, it's almost a game. I'm playing with the horse, and we're playing a game that I'm going to put pressure and I'm going to give you release. I'm going to put pressure and I'm going to give you release. I'm teaching you that I control your release, not you. I don't want you bucking and running off and rearing and kicking to get release. When you get release and you do that, then I'm teaching you, your learning and your horse mind, that when I do those things, that's how I get release. So the right answer is to kick, buck, and run off in order to get release. That's not good lessons to teach a horse. Sitting here, adjusting his hat, a lot of opportunities to get off. And again, I don't like a horse stalling. You see how long he's sitting here? When you're starting horses, you need to get on and get off. You need to have that horse doing something. When a horse can just think of, oh my God, what's going to happen next? I'm getting this pressure. I'm not being told to do anything. I can't move my feet. I call it stalling. Other people may call it something else. But all those things lets a horse get worked up in his mind. You don't want to do that when you're starting a horse. You want your horse kind of staying busy, focused on you, listening to you, responding, getting pressure, getting release, responding to you, not so much reacting to you. There's a difference between response and reacting. This horse is responding right now. He's giving his neck, okay?
600, fuck.
He moved his feet.
He couldn't even buck high enough to get your fat ass off.
He moved his feet. Let me try to mute these guys because they're... Again, this is a great opportunity to get off. Now, if he had spurred and kicked this horse may have not bucked. This horse wouldn't have bucked if he'd have got off the horse after we had some excesses. People want to look at the end picture when they're training horses. And you need to look at the next little success. This guy had huge successes in a lot of ways. He had a lot of failures, but he had a lot of successes. The horse let him hold his leg in his stirrup. The horse let him get on. The horse would have let him get off. The horse would have let him take his leg out of the stirrups. The horse would have done a lot of things, and he had a lot of successes with his horse, and the horse was working with him and trying. Now, the uneducated eye and the non-critical eye will look at this and say, man, that horse is crazy. That horse is going to hurt somebody. You should have a helmet on. You should lunge the horse 500 times. You should get this horse worn out. You should have this horse in a tie-down. There'd be all these crazy things. This horse was trying, being a good horse, and doing a lot of right things. He just wasn't getting any reward or any response from the human saying, good boy, you're doing the right thing. He may have got it verbally. He didn't get the physical release of pressure. He wasn't able to learn in his horse mind that this is the right answer if I do this. What he learned is the right answer is to be scared. I'm going to get pain. I'm going to get kicked in the ribs. I'm not going to get released. My only release is if I fight. And when I fight, I'm going to bow my head, and I'm going to do what I do when a predator's on my back. I've got to get it off because my life depends on it. I'm scared. If I don't get this guy off, I could be dead. He's hurting me. I could die in a minute. My instincts kick in, and I need to run off. And the horse learns, hey, right now the horse is thinking, man, I'm glad I figured out how to get released. Now I know the next time someone gets on me, I need to do that because that's the only way I'm going to get released. Bad lesson. Too bad. All right. The other video. Now this video right here, I don't like taking babies from mamas. That's just me personally. I think it's wrong. I don't like it. Maybe it's the male in me, the ego, the macho, whatever it is. You don't mess with a mom's kid or baby. You just don't do it. So, now there may be a reason for medical why I have this guy. I'm thinking this cow wasn't moving, and I'm thinking these guys had to get it standing up. I didn't see the video after this happened, so we'll go ahead and watch this video here. And this horse moves the cow off, and everybody's like, wow, this is a cow horse. This is a reining horse. You see the guy picking him up by the tail? He's trying to stimulate this horse and making it move. Because it's laying down. I think this cow laid down. And if it doesn't move, it's gonna die. It's not going to feed on the mama. So I think this guy is actually trying to help this baby. Now the mom don't know that. The mom's like, you got my baby. I got to protect it. I'm trying to move in. And the horse is moving. So there's a lot of things going on here. I'm talking about the guy. Most people are probably watching this horse right now. So I probably should have got the horse out of the way first. Horse is pinning his ears, dropping his butt. He's staying in between his rider. Obviously, he's done this before. Notice the baby's walking now. Notice he's kind of spanking him, saying walk. He's getting this horse stimulated so it's going to go to his mama and maybe start feeding and drinking. Maybe he saw the calf born. So I don't necessarily think this is a bad, these guys are being mean or bad. And maybe they just did this to make a video for the horse, to show the horse. So now I'll go ahead and concentrate on the horse this time, talk about the horse. I'm thinking this stick right here is trying to keep the cow off. See that stick? And the bull ain't moving. So the horse obviously is going to come over there. Now some horses just naturally will push cow to remove him. You notice the horse isn't kicking? I mean, again, this is instinctive. A horse, and I don't know if this is a mule, he's got kind of big ears, but he's not biting or attacking the cow. He's merely keeping his butt. He's waving his tail. He's talking body language as cow. Look at those ears. Head down. Charging with the mouth. Spinning his butt. All these are threatening behaviors. All these things is how a horse defends himself. So this is a natural behavior that they've kind of, over time, you know, I guess you could put this horse on a lunge rope and put him in with a cow and move the cow around with a lunge rope and push him and make him push his cow. If a horse does something, a horse does best what they do most. So to teach a horse to do this, or this mule, I mean, I don't think it's that out of this world and hard. Everybody looks at this like, oh my God, that's a great horse. I wonder how they trained it, or that's a smart horse and he learned. A lot of this is instinctual. The horse is just instinctual, keeping his cow away. So we'll watch it one more time here. And, you know, mom's like, hey, you know, I want my baby to stay away. And again, I don't know if this, if they did this for the video, but they didn't hurt the cow. The horse moves in, spins his butt, talking, threatens to kick. Notice he's not kicking. If a horse doesn't have to kick, that's why when people get kicked, they go, a horse kicked me for no reason. No, he didn't. A horse will normally threaten you before he kicks, unless he's learned over time of people annoying him and not heeding his warnings. Then they learn that I have to kick, because humans don't learn that when I pin my ears, show my head, spin my butt, that means back away. This cow knows body language. He's not going to get kicked. Cow wants to come in. It has a draw to come in, but because this horse is working, staying between him and the baby, actually staying between him and the owner, I don't think he's protecting the baby. He's learning to push and dominate. A lot of natural instincts, again, a horse is a dominant horse. A horse likes to be higher. The cow is lower. The cow backed away. Now, if this cow had horns, then horn the horse probably wouldn't do this. If you were training this horse and you got an aggressive cow and it hurt the horse probably wouldn't do this. When we're teaching dogs to attack people, the person always has to run away and let the dog win. The first few bites, as soon as the dog bites somebody, the bad guy, the person playing the bad guy, runs away. And then we praise the dog and say, good job. So we have to teach the dog that he's bad and that people will run away from him. If you just, and you know, you got to know what you're doing when you're decoying and training a new dog, even if you're the bad guy, because if you get too aggressive and you hurt that dog on the first few bites or you push him too much, you can ruin him and you make him scared. And it's very hard to undo. Same way with horses. You put this horse in with an aggressive cow and he gets hurt, it's going to take a long time before this horse builds his confidence back up that I can push a cow and I'm not going to get hurt. So those are two videos. Figured I'd talk about them. I'm at 17 minutes here. Hang on. Oh, man, that's a good coffee. All right, we'll end that there. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good.